Right, well, it's a nice day. The snow is starting to melt quickly, so I figured if I'm going to test it in the snow, I better get to it. So I'm going to drop the blade off here, and then we'll take it across and go drive this thing through some snow. Right, we knocked the plow off it there. Victor's going to jump on it and drive it down the field, or drive it down to the field. Then we'll see what it does. All right, Victor coming up the trail there. Then I'll get him to run the camera, and I'll take off into the field and see how it does. Well, I'll do the customary test of just driving it out around in this field. There's still lots of snow to test it in. Probably about a foot still. 10 inches, 12 inches, somewhere around there. I predict it should go fine through it straight, but I think it's going to have a trouble steering. But we'll see what happens. Well, steering. I did expect it to drive through it quite well because it is kind of packy now. It's not so light and fluffy, but there's still lots of snow here. I'll show you the hole I just kicked in the track of it here. So still lots of snow here. It's probably riding up on it, maybe 4 or 5 inches still. And that's in the track of it. It'll kick you a hole in the fresh snow. So there's the depth of the snow there. There's my knee. So I'd say there's still about 12 inches of snow. But it turns well. It just, it doesn't turn overly sharp. But I'd say it probably turns about as sharp as the Oliver does anyway. But once you got used to that, it would be fine to drive through the woods. So let's take it for a test drive. See how it does in the woods. What we're gonna do is Victor's gonna get the 9N running and then we'll compare it to this. We'll see how the 9N does in the snow. It should go in the snow, but we'll never know until we try. So we'll get that going and we'll try it out there first. All right. Sorry I missed firing up there, but it didn't take much. We just checked all the fluids, gave it a little bit of choke, turned on the fuel, touched the button, it fired right up like nothing. And it has some gas in it, so figured worst case it's gonna run out. But anyways, should be able to have some fun with it before that. First things first, will it pull itself out of the spot it's sunken into right now? Victor gave it a 50-50 chance. So let's see what happens. Well, let's see if we can get out of there. Get some rocking going. Beautiful. Now we'll see how it does in the field. I think it'll be fine. should be able to follow me around. Get some good video for you guys. Worst case, I guess you'll get stuck. But really, it's going not too bad at all. Now. the 9N doing a bit of spinning here, but it chewed its way through. That is a good little tractor, man. Oh, just about got stopped in the snow crown, but it chewed its way down. You just run into the snow crown on the other side.
That's embarrassing.
Didn't slip at all going up the hill, so the tracks did get better traction than just the tires. The tractor itself is having some issues, so when it's going under load, it's wanting to stall. So that could maybe be that cheap carburetor I put on, and I'm gonna have to probably find a better one for it. For now, it's working all right, but just doing stuff like that, it doesn't seem to like. But anyways, I'll have to fix that. But we'll travel back down to where the tractors park and see how that goes anyway. Well, Vic was coming up the hill, thought he'd try to cut across here. Come on. Man, that is a good little tractor though. All right, let's get going. So I'm just driving up the trail right now and I'm not on much of a hill and it's dying. I'm wondering if that fuel filter's actually clogged up on us again. Able to get going now, so best thing to do I guess is to boogie on back down to the other end of the field and then we'll have to look into it. This one didn't spit and sputter too much on the way back. I'm wondering if it's losing its gravity feed to the carburetor when it's going uphill for some reason. Oh, nine ends off. We just shut the fuel off in them. And the half track's off. Well, anyways, that seems like a problem for another day. We'll have to look in that when we get a chance. So for now, thanks for watching.